Yeah, good afternoon, honored guests.
我们的亲爱的贵宾，下午好。
Brothers and sisters in the Lord.
弟兄姐妹们，你们好。
Yeah, this afternoon just make a quick sharing.
我在这里要做一个非常短的一个分享。It
gave me a great pleasure to share with you the goodness of God for Petra.
能够来分享神的这个良善美好是非常荣耀的一件事情。
He loves us so much that He always makes special provision for us.
他非常的爱我们，所以他每一次都提供特别的供应。
About 5 years ago, when Petra was told that we have to look for a new place,
当五年前我们这个滨海磐石说要找一个新的这一个聚会场所的时候,
at that time we were still in China Square.
那个时候我们还在这个中国广场那里,
and China Square has already planned to tear down the place and rebuild by end of 2017.
在那个时候他们已经计划了2017年的时候整个中国广场会重新的装修。
Certainly, we all go into action, start looking for an alternative location.
所以当时我们就开始行动了，要去找另外一个地方来替代我们聚会的场所。
We went around and I guess estimate that we have seen at least not less than 30 places.
我们整个新加坡都走遍了，我们大概看了大概有不下于这个30个地方。
We even have signed one place and we deposit even been placed. On that place.
我们甚至是下了一个定金, 说要跟另外一个地方签一个比较长的租赁合约。
And the deal did not go through.
但是给了定金也, 但是最后还是不成交。
We were so desperate that we were even looking about merger with another church so we can use their place.
我们甚至非常的, 那时候非常的迫切了, 我们想还是想过是要跟另外一个教会合并, 然后我们可以用他的场所。
So desperate time need desperate actions.
很多时候在这种时候, 我们就做出一个不同的一种决定。
But the Lord has His own plan for us.
但是我们的神却有他的美意。
So we decided, as the board decided, that we will just temporarily park ourselves in another location.
所以当时我们这个理事会就决定在暂时在一个地方, 租另外一个地方。
So by end of 2017, we pack our bag, we carry our hand luggage to City Hub.
所以在2017年的那个年终的时候, 我们就打包好我们的行李, 就去到 City Hub 这个地方。
We carry nothing with us. Everything was left behind. Just only the hand luggage.
我们没什么东西都没拿，我们只拿了我们的行李，就轻装上阵了。
And we actually deposited and kept our 350 chairs that we are sitting today in a warehouse.
但是我们当时就留着我们在中国广场那350张椅子，就是你们现在坐的那350张，我们就把它放在一个仓库里头。
So we believe God has a better place for us.
因为当时我们就信靠神，知道他会给我们一个更美的地方。
So we waited for our promised land.
所以我们在等待的就是那个应许之地。
And then in June 2018,
所以在2018年6月份的时候,
I believe God moved Bible House to call us.
我相信神感动了这个圣经公会的人来打电话给我们。
Thank you, General Secretary Ezekiel, that we received a call from Bible House.
我们就从那里接受得了一个电话，谢谢他。
And then immediately, Pastor John and I met up with Reverend Ezekiel.
所以当时高凯牧师和这个郑泰生就跟这个圣经公会的人联系。
And the first offer we were given was, would you sign 25 years lease?
首先他要让我们说，哎，是否你可以签一个租赁是25年之久的。
I took my calculator as usual and I started keying the number.
他的袋子里时常都装着一个小计算机，就拿出来计算一下，可以不可以？
I said, well, I think we can consider 20 years.
那时算了之后，他就决定，我们就讨论了，就说20年是可以的。
So the rest is history.
所以过后以后，这些你们都知道已经成为历史。
In fact, at that time, nobody knows that Bible House B2 was even available.
没有人，其实没有外界没有人知道说Bible House圣经大厦这个地方的底层，第二层是有能够出租的。
And I believe it's divine, and we are really honored to be approached.
我们很感到高兴，也知道是神圣的，神预备了这个地方给我们。
To Petra, a small unknown church.
对我们来讲，
滨海磐石有
滨海磐石有许许多多的教会在找地方，但是我们滨海磐石就是被呼召找到这样的一个地方。感谢主。
For 20 years, Petra has moved to 5 locations.
在过去的那二十年，我们滨海磐石就搬了大概五个不同的地方。
So this is our 6th move.
这个是我们第六个地方。
And this is the first time we called it a home.
所以这个地方开始，我们才称为一个家。
Because to many, they realize it's the first time a home that we have our own toilet.
对于每一个人来讲，你知道吗？为什么我们称为一个家呢？这个是第一次我们自己的教会里面拥有自己的厕所，很重要。
For the last 20 years, we've shared toilet with somebody else.
过去那二十年，我们租用的另外一个地方都是公用的厕所。
So many prophetic words have been spoken to Petra over the years.
过去那二十年，有很多预言性的预言发生在我们这个教会。
I personally believe that God has reserved this promised land to fulfill His calling.
我相信神就是把这个地方保留了，他的那个应许之地是围着他给我们的呼召。
For Petra to plan for the next generation.
是让我们滨海磐石是要围着另外的那二十年来计划。
You saw the next generation just now when we started the service, where they sang you a song.
对，聚会开始的时候，我们看到那下二十年就是他们要借这个棒子了。
And I believe for this promised land, I call this as Petra Reset.
在为了这个应许之地，我们这个滨海磐石，我们所称的就是说重新再来。
And it's Petra 2.0.
就是如果有这个版本的话，就是滨海磐石 2.0 版本。
It's for the next 20 years.
就是围着另外的那二十年。
In 2020.
就是二零，今天是2020了哈，二零，就是2020年。
We are looking forward to God to move in the next 20 years.
我们在期待神在另外那二十年在这里大大的运行。
And next, I'd like to share.
接着下来我要分享。
That in May 2018,
在2018年五月份的时候
，Petra had its 20th AGM annual general meetings.
在这一个滨海磐石，我们有我们的这个常年礼常年大会，就是每年的五月份，那时候是第二十年的常年大会。
It was in that AGM that the board and the member had passed the resolutions.
就在那个常年大会的时候，我们就passed the resolution. 突然间忘记怎么讲了，就是通过了一个议决。对了，哎呀，谢谢你啊。
And
决议。
Okay. The member has given the board the so-called the authority or the mandate to establish a company limited by guarantee.
就在那个时候，这个会员他们就给了我们这个权利，就开始建立了一间这一个公司。
Because the board has done some research and done some background due diligence, and we believe that we like to switch from society into company limited by guarantee.
所以那个时候的理事会，我们就决定也做了一些这个调查，就是决定把我们注册的以前注册的这一个所谓的社团变成一间公司。
And that's to switch the so-called the legal structure.
就把整个这个法律性的一个构造、一个架构改变过来了。
Can I have the slide up? 嗯。So as a result of that, the AGM.
就在那个常年大会的时候呢
Petra has submitted our application to ACRA, and then we got our approval on the 30th of January last year.
就在last year, 就在去年1月30号的时候，滨海磐石就成立了这一间有限公司，担保有限公司。
So having registered as a legal company, we have to apply to the charity board.
当我们成立了这间公司之后呢，我们还得要申请有这个慈善的准证。
It was only on November 15, last year, just about more than a month ago, that we got our approval as a charity status.
所以其实我们申请了有相当久的一段时间，就是在去年11月15号的时候，我们被批准了拥有了这个慈善组织的这个准证。
So today, I'm pleased to declare to you that we will be from now known as Petra Community.
从现在开始，我们的名称就叫做滨，我们华语很简单，还是没有变，滨海磐石。哎，要拍掌哦。
The next slide. So what is then from here going forward?
从现在到过后，我们会怎么样呢？下一步应该是什么呢？
So just now that we have to, the next step is to migrate current Petra Church operations and all the assets and everything into the new setup called Petra Community.
所以下一步呢，因为以前是一个社团的组织一个教会，所以现在我们就逐渐把所有的资产和运行转移到这个滨海磐石。
And so you will be now known as Petra Community as you probably come in. If you have noticed it, even on the board upstairs, B2 is Petra Community, not Petra Church.
所以可能你刚走进来的时候，你会发现有一些已经不一样了。我们没有把教会这两个字放在里头，是滨海磐石。我们正式的成立了一个团体，一个大家庭。
The board has been relooking at how to move forward with the congregations.
我们 整个理事会也在看怎么样把整个会众推向更新的。
Some years ago, Pastor John had been passionately, you know, preaching and delivering the message of church community, I mean the kingdom community. Kingdom community,
yeah. Yeah.
It is a kind of a paradigm shift for our church to do church differently.
这个也是让我们知道，现在我们从现在开始，我们做办教会是跟以前的思维不一样，我们要把它转变过来。
It is all about a lifestyle of each individual, each saint living true to his or her priesthood.
就是说，每一个会友都要根据他的那个祭司的身份，能够在会众，在无论你神把你放在哪里，把它活出来。So
to fulfill the church visions of raising sons and daughters to reveal the God's glory.
所以要依据我们的意向，就是要培育神的儿女来彰显神的这个荣耀就在我们当中。So
to raise our own sons and daughter, we need to give birth. To the children.
所以，如果我们要培育我们的自己的孩子的话，这样首先我们必须要把他们诞生出来呀。And
I'm excited that last 3 months, from September to November of 2019.
所以我很高兴的要告诉你们，从去年九月份到这个十一月份的时候，那过去的三个月。
The church did another so-called happiness group run.
我们就做了这个幸福小组的第三期。
And with the seven group, with seven small group.
当时我们主办的这个幸福小组有七组.
We all experienced the power and the word of God among the seven groups.
我们在这七组里面经历到的这个神的话语是很信实有大能的在当中运行.
And we saw about 50 salvations.
我们一共有50个救恩，所以一切的荣耀都要归给我们的神.
And that is the birth the Lord wants us to raise.
这个也就是神要我们在围着他的国度而有新生而诞生在我们当中.
The train has left the stations.
这个火车头已经开跑了.
There are many stops that we all can get on board.
每一个站都可以允许，也容许，也欢迎很多人来进入这个火车。We like to have
all Petra to come on board.
我们希望所有的会友跟我们一起。
And soon we'll be putting up the ticket for sales.
我们很快就要售票了哈。
God bless Petra.
神要大大的祝福滨海磐石。
Thank you.
谢谢。